Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich, a developer evangelist at Docusign. I'm here in the Docusign studio with Mike Friel, who is a senior software engineer responsible for building and maintaining the room's interface. Mike, it is great to have you on the show and to be in San Francisco.
Matt, thanks for having me.
So in the real estate and mortgage industries, transactions often require agents to complete many tasks, including downloading, printing, scanning, and emailing documents back and forth. On this episode of Developer Deep Dive, we take a look at the Rooms API V2, which enables developers to automate and simplify the completion of agreement packages. So Mike, that was a lot of words. Can you explain to our developer community what this product really is?
Sure, it's actually a family of products. We have Rooms for real estate, which is to assist residential real estate brokerages, and we have Rooms for mortgage, which is for lenders like banks, credit unions, and other non-bank lenders. The API supports both, though.
Excellent. So in the interest of time, let's talk about the Rooms API as it relates to Rooms for real estate. So my understanding, brokerages and their realtors often manually manage the entire transaction process, not just the signing step, right? There is downloading, printing, scanning, emailing, that kind of happens beforehand. These kind of tasks lead to wasted time, frustrated agents, and some compliance problems. So how does DocuSign Rooms for real estate help manage these challenges?
Well, I could tell you, but instead I think Sarah Mitchell, one of our Rooms product managers, should tell you.
Excellent. Over to you, Sarah.
Thanks, Matt. Rooms is designed to help digitally manage the entire transaction, not just the signing step. So agents are easily guided through the steps necessary to complete a transaction and can leverage our e-signature solution all from within a single app. You can think of Rooms as a virtual workspace to collaborate on complex deals. And Rooms for real estate, each room typically represents a property an agent is working on. So we jumped into this listing here. You can see I have all of the relevant data for this deal in one place. Easy access for me as the agent, and my broker has visibility into the deal's details. The document section makes it easy for me to upload, manage, share, and send documents out for signature. And when they're done, I can quickly submit them for approval. Real estate transactions have so many different steps and phases, so we have these task lists, essentially a to-do list, to make sure nothing is missed and everything is reviewed and approved before it can be closed. The broker can define what's in these task lists so it supports their unique workflow. I can also invite people into the room and control what they can do, which makes it really easy to collaborate, especially when there's so many different parties involved in these deals. And with all the conversations that are going on, I can keep all of that information within our messages capability. So no more chasing down emails and text messages. Everything's captured in one place. And all of the activity that's going on in the entire room is captured, so I have a secure audit trail. So as the agent, once I've completed all the tasks and my client's ready to close, I can submit the entire deal for a final approval, save the agent time by making the submission easy, and as a broker, I love it, because I have a dashboard of things that need my attention, so I'm not becoming the bottleneck. I have peace of mind knowing every deal is completed correctly, reviewed, and safely stored.
Thank you, Sarah. Now, large brokerage firms presumably have to manage thousands of properties simultaneously, as opposed to creating simply, you know, one room at a time. As the volume of rooms created increases, enterprise customers will want to automate this process. So Mike, how can we use the API to resolve this challenge?
Well, instead of having to create each room individually, via the API, you can programmatically insert a large number of rooms. And also with the help of templates, you can have these rooms pre-populated with task lists, tasks, and even documents.
Excellent. Very cool. Do you have a demo of this that you could show us?
Definitely. So for this example, let's assume I'm an integrator that needs to create rooms. So through the API and leveraging task list templates and room templates, we'll be creating a room and adding a document via posts to the API endpoints.
Awesome, let's do it.
So the first thing we'll do is to create the room. So we're gonna create demo room number one, and there is some information that you need. For example, role ID, transaction side ID, template ID, which is the ID of the room template that I mentioned earlier. So those you can either get from the UI, or we have endpoints that will give you that information. Additionally, what we're going to do in this example is add the address information for this property.
Now, is that address information the only information that we can add in that body?
That is a good question, man. actually, no. So for this particular demo company that we have created, the rooms can have any of this information that is available here. So we just took a small subset of that information, and that's what we'll be adding at create time.
Right.
So any of this could be specified at create time or added subsequently. Okay, so the only other piece of information that we needed for this is the authorization token. So when you start playing around with the API, through DevCenter, we provide a mechanism for you to get an authorization token, which is through our OAuth token generator, which is what I did for this example. So once I got that, all I had to do was paste that into my token here in Postman, and I'm ready to go. So now we can send this off, and we get our response, and we have our new room ID. So next we'll be adding a document to that newly created room. So there are a couple different ways you can add a document. We can take it in Base64 or in binary format. If you do binary format, it would take two requests, one to create the document and one to specify its contents. So we're going to take the single request approach and specify our file contents in as a Base64 string. So I have previously converted my document to Base64 and pasted it in here. And now I will update our room ID and send that off. And now it's come back that our listing agreement PDF has been successfully created, and I have my document ID.
Yeah, let's see the newly created room in the UI.
So here's our list of rooms before we did our demo. And now we have our demo room number one. So I can now open this room, and you'll notice in our room details that we have our address information that was specified in our request, and also in going to documents, in addition to the task lists and task placeholders that were specified in our templates, we have the document that we added in our second request.
Oh, fantastic. And obviously this is just the baseline of functionality. You can do a ton more things.
Absolutely.
So Mike, where should developers go to get started with the Rooms API?
Developers can get started on the DocuSign Developer Center. We just released a brand new set of guides and code examples for the Rooms API. The code examples include things like creating a room with a template, exporting data from a room, and adding forms to a room.
And we showed the creating room with the template here today.
We did.
Perfect. Awesome. So if you are interested in trying this particular code example out for yourself, head to the DocuSign Developer Center. And Mike, thank you so much otherwise for being on the show today. And that is all the time we have today. Please join us next month when Callie Moss talks to Lamar Jordan about accessibility engineering. If you liked that video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest DocuSign developer content. If you want to see a specific topic in a future video, comment below. For everything else, visit the DocuSign Developer Center.